Shalom Israel. My name is Officer Kaya Duan of ISUPK Jamaica. ISUPK started 1 West 125th Street, Harlem, New York. ISUPK is run by Commanding General Yana. One man with rank and the authority to lead Israel at this time. I say the Awa Barsham Yawashai Bakatan to my brothers. The Awa Shamar Alatan Barsham Yawashai to my sisters. Alright, so today we're going to dispel some of the Rastafarian myths. And I mean about, and I mean Selassie being the King of Kings, and I mean that is one, and I mean another one is that Jerusalem is in Africa. That's another one talking about Israel is in Africa and all that madness. You understand? And the next one is that the Ark of the Covenant is in Ethiopia. You understand? So without further ado, we're going to jump straight into it. But remember to like the video, share, subscribe, you understand? Share by your personal Facebook page or your personal Twitter page. You know what I mean? Even on Instagram if you can, you understand? So without further ado, we're going to address the Ark of the Covenant first. You understand? So we're going to jump to the book of Galatians. Slap ya. I jump to the book of Galatians. Let us address Jerusalem first. See? Let us jump to the book of Galatians chapter 4 verse 26. And this is what it says. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free. So, you know what I mean? The scripture, we can know that Jerusalem is a free land. You know what I mean? Not free to the heathens, but you know what I mean? That is it's free because, you know what I mean? That's the homeland of the children of Israel. We are not free until we are in that land. You understand? Now we are living in Jamaica, where we were brought, dragged over here kicking and screaming to serve slavery. You understand? We are not free here in Jamaica because this is not our land. We are not free in North America. We are not free in, you know what I mean, South Central America, because this is not our homeland. Our homeland is Jerusalem. You understand? Continue reading. Which is the mother of us all. So you know about the rest of them love talk about, you know what I mean, Africa is the motherland. But according to the Bible, Jerusalem is our motherland. You understand? Not Africa. You know what I mean? We were sold by the Africans to the white man to serve slavery. You understand? Because they knew that Africa was not our motherland. We knew that Africa wasn't our motherland. Jerusalem is. You understand? But since we came over here now and pick up these idolatrous religions now, you know what I mean? They are teaching us that Africa is our motherland. And when they are trying to fit themselves or fit Africa into the Bible, they are now saying that Jerusalem is in Africa, but they are going to dispel that lie right now, according to the Bible. You understand? Alright, so we're going to jump to the book of Joshua, chapter 1. We're going to read from verse 2 to 4. And this is what it says. Moses, my servant, is dead. That is the Most High speaking. See? So Moses died. Now therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all these people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. So now the children of Israel was under Joshua, and Moses died. You know what I mean? And Joshua was the one who's going to bring them into the promised land. You understand? And the Most High said, go over the Jordan. We know that the Jordan River is in, you know what I mean, what the world calls the Middle East. You understand? Right? So this was the direction to their promised land. You know what I mean? So at this time, you know what I mean, they have conquered some lands and did the other side of Jordan, and now they are going over to conquer the rest of the lands over to Jordan, which that is the land that the Most High promised to them. You understand? Continue reading. See? Verse 3. Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. So this, you know what I mean, this is now telling you the land that the Most High promised to the children of Israel, you know what I mean, which we eventually call Jerusalem, you know what I mean, which is our motherland. You understand? So you know what I mean, the Most High is giving Joshua command to go over Jordan and go and get this land that I promised to you. You understand? So we know, say, the direction now is not, you know what I mean, let us, as a matter of fact, let us prove that the direction is not leading to Africa. You understand? Continue reading, verse 4. From the wilderness and this Lebanon, You know what I mean? Lebanon. So the Most High tell you, say, yo, from the wilderness where, you know what I mean, they are coming from, they understand, to Lebanon. You get to me, I say, where is Lebanon? Alright, let us go to Google Map. Zin, remember to like this video, you know what I mean? And remember to come out of this religion that never gives you proof of anything, but you know what I mean? But give you fake information, you know what I mean? Formulate it in a way that sounds nice, you know what I mean? But never gives you the proof as to what you are saying. But we are going to give you the proof. The proof. We in the ISUP and the commanding general, yeah, and we give you the proof. Alright, so here's Lebanon. You know what I mean? So Lebanon is here in the land that they call the Middle East. Here, right beside Lebanon, you see Syria. You know Syria is in the Middle East, right? Iraq, Jordan. Here is Jordan, right? Jordan is also in the Middle East. Remember, they cross the Jordan and they are heading to Lebanon. You understand? And here you can see a small piece of the land of Israel. You know what I mean? Let me see if we can scroll. You know what I mean? That is now occupied by the people claiming to be Israelites, right? And here is the place that they now call Jerusalem. But, you know what I mean? According to the Most High, it was the majority of this land that we call the Middle East. You understand? So let me continue reading. Slacking. So continue reading. Even unto the great river Philakia, the great river, the river Euphrates. Alright, so from Lebanon, see, remember, is leaving from Jordan, you understand, to Lebanon, to even to the great river Euphrates. And this is the river Euphrates, right in the middle of the Middle East. You understand? So all your Rastafari teacher, they might tell you, say, yo, you know what I mean? Jerusalem is in Africa. Jerusalem is not in Africa. You understand? Jerusalem is in the land that they call the Middle East right now. The same land that they are fighting over. You know what I mean? Because that land is full of so much resource. That was our own land, but we got kicked out because we broke the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. You understand? Which we implore you to come back to start keeping. Because unless we come back to these laws, statutes, and commandments, and come back to the Most High as a people, you know what I mean? Our captivity will be, you know what I mean, prolonged over here in the West. You understand? So there is proof that the land, you know what I mean, of Israel is not in Africa. You understand? The mountain and one of the Rastafari lies them. You understand? Alright, we're gonna jump to our next point. See? Alright. So another thing that Rasta like to say is that, you know what I mean, the Ark of the Covenant is in Ethiopia. See? Which we know that's a lie. You know what I mean? They sing so many songs about Ethiopia. You know what I mean? That, you know what I mean, that we should go to Ethiopia. And all these artists singing these songs, they never go to Ethiopia. They tell you that Ethiopia is the motherland, you know what I mean? Where they should migrate to, but they don't go to Ethiopia. You understand? They have the money, they have the resource to go to Ethiopia because they claim Selassie promised them some land in Ethiopia. The very Ethiopians that they sing about in the songs, you know what I mean, show them racism over there in Ethiopia and oppression, and did not give them any kind of citizenship. You understand? And one of the lies that convinced, you know what I mean, our people who are in the Rastafari religion to go over Ethiopia is that the Ark of the Covenant is there and it is not. You know what I mean? So we're going to jump to the book, book of 2 Maccabees chapter 2 verse 4, and we'll read down to 7, right? And the book of Maccabees is in the Apocrypha. The Apocrypha is 14 books stolen out of the Bible by the Roman Catholic Church, but these books are in the original King James 1611 Bible. You understand? Right, so we're going to read the book of 1 Maccabees chapter 2 verse 4. And this is what it says.
It was also contained in the same writings that the prophet, being warned of God, commanded the tabernacle and the ark to go with him as he went forth into the mountain where Moses climbed up and saw the heritage of God. So, you know what I mean? Jeremiah, right, is speaking about Jeremiah, right, was commanded to go up into the very mountain and carry the ark of the covenant into the very mountain that Moses, you know what I mean, went up and saw when the Most High showed him the land that he promised to the children of Israel. You understand? Continue reading. Verse 5, and when Jeremy, which is Jeremiah, see, came thither, he found an hollow cave where he laid the tabernacle and the ark and the altar of incense, and so stopped the door. So, you know what I mean? Jeremiah found a cave. Slakia. And he put the ark of the covenant, you know what I mean, and the other things them in the cave. You understand? Because at this time now, the Babylonians were coming to, you know what I mean, was our oppressor at that time, the Babylonians, you know what I mean? They capture Jerusalem, they capture our land, and we are now serving the Babylonians. So, you know what I mean? We never have any real government structure. We have to serve these heathens. So what the prophet tried to do was, you know what I mean, hide the Ark of the Covenant, which, you know what I mean, which was very important to the children of Israel, to our foreparents. You understand? Continue reading. Verse 6. And some of those that followed him came to mark the way, but they could not find it. You know what I mean? So some came to mark the way, but they couldn't find the way. Then continue reading. Verse 7. Which when Jeremy perceived, he blamed them, saying, as for that place, it shall be unknown until the time that God gather his people again together and receive them unto mercy. So Jeremy, you know what I mean, Jeremiah was angry at the people whose job it was to mark the place so he can come back and find the ark. But he realized that this was the act of the Most High. And then he said, we never find the ark again until the Most High gather in people. So nobody know where the ark is. Nobody can find it. It is in a cave in the same mountain that Moses went up and saw the land that the Most High promised to the children of Israel. But nobody can find it or access it. You understand? Because the Most High hid the Ark of the Covenant after Jeremiah put it in the cave. You understand? So the Ark of the Covenant is not in Ethiopia. It's not in Ethiopia. You understand? And you know what I mean? So you see where the Rastafari religion is built based off of lies and speculation. One other lie is that Solomon had sex with the Queen of Sheba, and that is also a lie. You understand? Alright. We're gonna prove to you that Selassie is not no King of Kings and he's not no Lord of Lords. Let me rephrase that. We're going to prove to you that Selassie is not the King of Kings and Lord of Lords that the Bible is talking about. You understand? Which we know that that term predominantly comes from the Bible. The popularity of that term comes from the Bible. And that is what they are trying to associate Selassie as being the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You understand? But we're trying to tell you that, you know what I mean? Selassie is not no King of Kings. And he's not no Lord of Lord. You understand? And this is the scripture. So we are going to the scripture that reads King of King and Lord of Lord. This is Revelation chapter 19. We'll start at verse 11 to 16. See? And this is what it says. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he does judge and make war. And this is important, you know. You know what I mean? So the scripture is telling you about Yahawashi, who we were called Jesus Christ, because Revelation is a book about the revealing of Yahawashi. It says it. You understand? The word revelation actually means to reveal. When it starts, it says this is the revelation of Jesus Christ, or Yahawashi Mashiach in the Hebrew. See? it is not talking about nobody else, right? And it says, Slakia, let me read it again. And I saw heaven open, and behold, a white horse, and he that sat on him was called Faithful and True, and in righteousness he does judge and make war. Zin, all right, question. What war did Selassie make? And what judgment did Selassie come to carry out? You know what I mean? You might say the war with Mussolini. But remember, you know, Selassie had to flee to the Queen of England for support. You understand, in order to defeat Mussolini, after Mussolini was defeating him. You understand, in that war. You understand? So this is not talking about Selassie. You understand? And we soon reach the scripture, we say King of King and Lord of Lord. Right? And so far, this does not match Selassie. Continue reading. Verse 12. His eyes were as a flame of fire. Why it says Christ's eye was like a flame of fire? Because he was angry. Christ was angry for the oppression that was done to his people. And he's coming to make war to free his people. You understand? He's angry about the slavery that we went through under the oppressor. And he's coming to make, you know what I mean? Make, you know, to balance the scale, to come and carry out justice for his people. He's angry about the oppression that we are under right now. You understand, as a people. You know what I mean? All the robbery, you know what I mean? And the exploitation from the other nations. Christ is angry about that. You know what I mean? When he sees that, his eyes become red like fire. If you watch any show or any animation, when you see a man eye red like fire, it shows you that he's angry. And that is, out of the Bible, is where that them get that imagery from. You understand? And take that out of the scriptures. That's why you see in the cartoons when, you know what I mean, when the cartoon character get angry, is their eyes become like fire. Because they get that out of the scriptures. And many of these movies that you see, you know what I mean, not to stray from the point, but many of these movies that you see on TV, them get the storyline out of the Bible. Everybody steal from the Bible, steal from our records. But they never tell you that the Bible is talking about you and your people. You understand? Continue reading. His eyes were as a flame of fire, and his head were many crowns. Why was there many crowns on his head? There wasn't, you know, all right, let me first say this. The reason why there was many crowns on his head, because he came to judge in righteousness and to make war, meaning he's going to take other people's crowns. He wasn't wearing them crown literally, but he was going to conquer kingdoms. You understand? So when Christ comes, he's going to defeat America. He's going to defeat Britain. He's going to defeat France. You know what I mean? He's going to defeat Italy. He's going to defeat all the rulers, all the ruling kingdoms of this earth. Russia, everybody. That is the reason why, you know what I mean, he had many crowns on his head. This was a metaphor. He didn't have literal crowns on his head. But he defeated all these kingdoms, making him the king now. Of all these kingdoms, you see, right? When did Selassie come and conquer many kingdoms? Selassie never come and conquer not one kingdom. All Selassie did was oppress his people. All Selassie did was starve his people in a famine. Meanwhile, he was living lavishly and squandering his country's money and resources, while his people were suffering in a famine. You understand? And had to flee to the Queen of England for support. You understand? When his enemies was upon him. You understand? Continue reading. Verse 3. See up here. Let me continue reading verse 12. And he had a name written that no man knew but he himself, meaning a reputation that no man knew. Why say he had a reputation? Your name is a reputation, you know. See? He had a reputation that no man knew, because the first time Christ came, he came peacefully to die for the sins of Israel. You understand? But now he might come with a different name, a different reputation. He might come to make war, and instead of being the person, you know what I mean, the Lamb of God that was sacrificed, he might come to be the conquering king. So that is the new reputation that no man know but himself. Only Christ knew what he was capable of while he was on those, on that cross. While they were killing him, while the heathens were killing Christ, our King. You know what I mean? Christ could have saved himself. But only he knew that. But knowing him forward, guess what going to go on? He going to show them when really capable of. Because he knows, he know when capable of. This is his reputation that you don't know about. You know what I mean? This is his capability, his name. You understand? Let me continue reading. Continue reading. Verse 30. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. Why was he clothed in a vesture dipped in blood? Because when you tread the battlefield in a road boy, and you're killing him, and you're killing, and you're killing, your clothes are stained with blood. So he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood. So Christ is not coming back to, you know what I mean, to give hugs and kisses. Christ is coming back to make war with this evil kingdom. You understand? Continue reading. And his name is called the Word of God. Why is it called the Word of God? Because all these things are written up in the Bible. The Bible is the Word of God. That is his reputation, the Word of God, that he's coming to make war, like the Bible says. You understand? His name is the Word of God. Continue reading. Verse 14. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses. So he's coming back with the angels. And the angels are not white babies with wings. The angels are not white men with wings. The angels are warriors. And they are coming back to conquer this earth. You understand? Continue reading. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses. Not literal white horses. You understand? We are talking about the chariots of the Most High. You know what I mean? Which, you know what I mean? The American government and the governments of this world is telling you that they have been seen, you know what I mean, UFOs and, you know what I mean, all these unidentified flying objects all across the world. It's no longer a secret. Everybody is seeing it. The regular man, you know what I mean, might even be seeing it. You understand? So they're coming back. You know what I mean? Yahweh Shai Mashiach is coming back with the angels to execute judgment on this world. You understand? Something that your Christian pastor don't teach. You know what I mean? Something that your Christian pastor skip over because he wants your money and he don't want to frighten you. You understand? Continue reading. And the armies which were in heaven followed him with white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. Continue reading. Verse 15. And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nation. It doesn't mean that a sword came out of his mouth literally, but the words that he spoke was as if, you know what I mean, you were being cut with a sword. Because when he's coming back, he's going to judge this world according to the crimes that they committed against the Most High people. For slavery, for the KKK killing off black people. You understand? For the slave plantations in Jamaica. You understand? For the oppressive system that still have us killing each other today. You understand? For all the exploits and all the oppression. You know what I mean? Done to the children of Israel. He's going to charge this wicked world for the evil that they have done. And it's going to cut them like a sword. You understand? When they realize what they have done to the Most High chosen people. You understand? Continue reading. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. That don't sound like Christ is coming back to give hugs and kisses. You understand? And surely Selassie never come and rule with a rod of iron. And he did not come with the armies of heaven neither. So this is not talking about Selassie. We soon get to the kings of kings and lord of lord part. You see? Continue reading. And he treaded the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. So he's coming to carry out the judgment of God. He's coming to do the Most High will. And when it says to tread the winepress of the wrath of the Almighty God, a winepress is where you tread the grapes to make wine. And when you step on grapes, it looks like your clothes is bloody. You understand when you step on, you know what I mean, bunch of grapes, it splash by your clothes and it look like blood. So it's coming to tread the wine press, meaning, like the scripture before said, his vesture will be dipped in blood. You understand? Because he's coming to do a lot of killing. You understand? He's gonna, trust me, this is, it's gonna be a sight to see. Let's hope you're not here to see it. You know what I mean? Let's hope you're not here on the earth when he comes to carry out that judgment and fall in the midst of it. You understand? Let's hope you're on the chariots. You know what I mean? When he comes back to carry out his judgment, because it won't be a pleasant sight. You know what I mean? Continue reading. Verse 16. And he has on his vesture and on his tie a name written, King of King and Lord of Lord. Right? This is similar to when it says he had many crowns on his head, because a King of King is a king over kings. Right? And a Lord of Lord is a Lord above all lords. See? For example, Joe Biden right now is a King of King, because he is the king of the country that rules the earth. You understand? Everybody else are subordinate to him. You know what I mean? If he makes a decision, you know what I mean? He have the power, you know what I mean, to make that decision. You know what I mean? Goes right across the board. He's king over these other smaller kings, like, you know what I mean? Like Germany, you know what I mean? Like France. That is what a King of King is, you know? You know what I mean? Selassie wasn't no king of no kings. Selassie only in Ethiopia, not even the other African countries considered Selassie king. So all is this talking about Selassie? You understand? But when Christ come, he will be called King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Why? Because when he done executing judgment, there will be no one able to stand before him. He will be the king of this earth. You understand? So just to show you that, you know what I mean, Selassie is not the King of Kings one. You know what I mean? The Ark of the Covenant is not in Africa, in Ethiopia. And Jerusalem is not in Africa. You understand? Again, where the ISUPK and the commanding general, your honor, you know what I mean? We keep classes on Sundays, 3 p.m., Monday at 7 p.m., and Wednesday. See, like here, Tuesday at 7 p.m., and Wednesdays at 7 p.m. You know what I mean? Remember to like the video, share on all social media platforms. Leave in the comments, you know what I mean? One thing. You understand? And with that, shalom.